set to go. We definitely do not want to play pressure this deck. Well, I'm fairly greedy for those of you used to watching lots of these videos. I'm sure you've yelled at him plenty of times. On the draw, I'm going to keep this though. A little greedy, like I said, but always happens. You always double play first. You get that little tingle. But, we'll see how we end up. Not a lot of pressure. And he's obviously the white leather. That's a good one. I'm going to wait a little bit. No reason to pass up. Three color after. Right out of the gates. He's going to trade both those guys for my guy. I'm pretty excited. So, you will make that trade. Awesome. That's the kind of thing you kind of hope for when you keep a hand like this, is getting some early two for one. Didn't really expect that one to happen, but that stole all of our Seagate Oracles. Seagate is in gas this turn. I could see beyond. Definitely feel awkward for playing my land there, but it's okay because we're going to play this guy and double up at the same turn. What do we got? A Heart Beast. I don't know what he gets here. Hope it's not a Drake Umber. Anything else I feel okay about? Domestication. Okay, well, we are definitely not playing the Google Drive stuff anytime soon. We're not going to level this guy up either. There's no real reason to. We are going to run this guy out. We want to either get rid of that domestication or be able to get this guy straight to level 4 at the same time before we play him, because although our opponent can't really use him, it's still kicking jump when blue light otherwise should not be able to get him. He's obviously flashing up or something, but unless it's a point flash, he still can't do that very easily. Normally a scary thing, not that scary right now. I'll level this guy up two times and make him steal it now. If he doesn't, I'll have a 5-5 next turn. So, excuse me, 6-6 even. I'm just gonna dome this now. I guess he's not wearing a laser speed, but oh shoot, I probably have an arrow on my turn. Yep, give her that domestication. Which is good for us because he can't even meet the guy 6-6 or anything, so get this guy going. 3-2-2-2. And there's no real need to put the guard gun over here. We're not going to have any pressure or anything. But, we don't really need this guy unless we draw a pathway to get here. So, I have this ready removal ready. Yep. Just come out of there. Okay. He has cast the CD on and whatnot, so. Is this a Deathless Angel? Luckily, we have a guard going to go out. Level this guy up a little bit. Kind of interesting. I'm gonna dash with the dead drone. Doesn't really have the block for it. we're gonna that's fine, we're gonna kill both of you guys. Which is fine by me. The less guys he has out with the special changes, the better. I mean, this guy can really pick off most things, so. And then we have the Bloodline Joker kind of come up back with feedback. 3 CJ locals and a CD on. Pretty crazy. Be good eventually. We're at 9 men right now. It's fine by me. We are going to knock this guy off. 23. This guy might just be able to ride us to victory on his own. If he were to land, it'd be awesome. Biggie. Domestication's probably a splinter twin. Alright. Did not really foresee that. Dreamstone heat is a good one. That gets us to a pathfinder who is huge and should be able to win a game for us. We're just going to pass the turn here and see what he tries to spin into him. I mean, he can't, still can't get fast guards on the door. He could throw it on his totem guard heartbeat for like, big deal. He could throw it on this guy and try to level up 5 times every turn. I don't know what he's thinking, leveling that guy up. If he tries to spin into that guy and then make copies and level it up, we're definitely set because the token comes in play with 0 level up counters. With the dome that guy.